that you cannot listen to God. Look at Jezebel, who was beautiful. Love of this world,
love of this world,
brought us down. If you think that you are very wise, that you can no longer listen to God. Look at Solomon, who was very wise. Love of wisdom brought him down. And if you think that you are very brave, that you can no longer listen to the advice from the Lord, look at King Saul, who was very brave, disobedient. Praise the Lord. Children, no matter who you are, no matter the level you've attained in life, the only way you can succeed in this life is through the Word of God. As I always say, when you are inclined to the Word of God, you will never be wayward. Today, we have many wayward preachers, many wayward children of God, many wayward people out there. The only way that can keep that sort of waywardness from you, the only thing that can destroy that waywardness, is the Word of God. Brother, this morning we have a word before us, as always, and it's titled, Be Free from Hell and Condemnation. Be free from hell and condemnation. It's a straight word. It's like, I'm just telling you, be free. Just like that. But I love the people of old. When our brother John the Baptist was telling them, run from this, run from that, be free from the wrath that is coming. And they came to him and asked him, what do we do? What do we do to be able to run from this wrath that you are talking about? And he told them, do this, do that, and do that. This morning, the Lord is telling us also, we should be free from hell and condemnation. What I should ask myself, and what you should ask yourself, is this. What do I do to be free? Does freedom just come like that? Is it possible just to be free like that? What battle do I need to fight to be free? And this morning, the Lord is going to tell us what we should do that will enhance our freedom from hell and condemnation. And these two things the Lord is talking about right now, some souls have already been doomed in them. As we are talking right now, your grandfather, your grandmother, some of your friends that died some times ago, they are already in this place we are talking about. They are already languishing in hell. And it pleases the Lord to come and let me know and let you know that we can be free from them. We can be free from that place that people are languishing now. It is possible to be free. So what do we do? Remember that three things you will have in mind. With these three things, freedom is sure for you. Last night, the Lord was telling me, he said, your freedom is not when you come to my judgment seat. Your freedom is here right now. If you are condemned on earth here, when you get to me, I will condemn you. You cannot repent when you get to me already. If you want to be free, you must be free here right now. Because if you get to me, is what you are on earth here, I will use to judge you there. If you are already free on earth, when you come to me, you are free. And if you are condemned here already, if you come to me on my judgment seat, I will condemn you. So, after the service this morning, after this preaching, if you were condemned before, the Lord shall set you free in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, the Bible told us in the book of 1 Corinthians, this one was not there before, it just came now. 1 Corinthians chapter number 11 from verse 31. Say, for if we would judge ourselves now, we shall not be judged again when we get there. Once you get to the judgment seat of God, what you need to do is to say, Lord, I'm here. Thank you. We say, okay, thank you, my son. He will hug you. But if you refuse to judge yourself now, if you are under the list of condemnation here on earth, once you get to him, you are condemned already. If we judge ourselves now, we will not be judged again. Say, but when we are judged, verse 3, we are chastened of the Lord that we should not be condemned with the world. But when we are judged, when you judge yourself now, tell yourself, hey, I think I am a fornicator. I better leave it now. I know every fornicator shall be destroyed. So I have to leave that sin of fornication. If you judge yourself now and condemn yourself and repent now, if you get there on that day, you will not be condemned again. Praise Master Jesus. So what are the three things you need to do? For you to be free from hell and condemnation, as I've said just now, judge yourself and repent of that judgment you have judged yourself. And the most three important thing you need to do is to one, love God, fear him, and run from sin. Love God, fear him, and what? Run from sin. If you can do these three things, if you can love God, fear him, and run away from sin, I tell you, you are free from hell forever. Praise Master Jesus. Because if you love God, as he told us in the book of John 14, verse 15, John 14, 15 says, if you love me, keep my commandment. If you love God, you will keep his commandment. Say, if you love me, first of all, let us develop love for the Lord. If you love God, you wouldn't want to offend him. You wouldn't want to sin against him. It's like a man that loves the friend or the wife, or the wife that loves the wife, the husband. You will do everything to make sure whatever he says, you do it so that you will not offend him. So if you love God, you will keep his commandment and you will not sin against him. Remember, it is sin that condemns a man. Praise Master Jesus. And fear him. Fear him. I said love him. Fear him. And what? Run from sin. Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 30 have this to say. Ecclesiastes 12 30 says, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Say, fear God. This is the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandment. Do you want to be free from hell? It is possible, Sister Tony Abosede. It is possible to be free from hell. Do you want to be free from condemnation and destruction? It is possible. Love God. If you love him, you keep his commandments. And if you fear him, you will fear his wrath. You will know that the Lord is, the anger of the Lord is tempestuous. The anger of the Lord is destructive. So you wouldn't want to incur that wrath. You will fear him and run from whatever that will make him to be angry with you. It's like a child who fears their father. He do everything possible to make sure he runs from whatever offends his father. So the Lord is telling us today that I can be free from condemnation. I can be free from that pit of hell that people are falling into like rain. As we are talking right now, people are jumping into hell like rain. But we can escape it. It is possible for Sister Hezibah to escape it if she loves God genuinely, not hypocritically. If she fears God genuinely, she will run from sin and keep my commandment. For this is the whole duty of man. I'm reading Ecclesiastes chapter 12 and 13. Let us hear the conclusion of the matter. Fear God, keep his commandment, for this is the whole duty of man. And if I can keep this duty, and you are able to keep this duty, I'm telling you, our salvation is sure. Our salvation is secure. How do you fear the Lord? You have the fear of God in you. If you fear him, you will not commit that sin you are committing. If you fear him before you do everything, anything, you will consider him first. You will remember somebody's watching you. You will remember a time is coming that you will stand before him. You will remember that if you die in that sin, he will destroy you. So what do you do? Whatever you do, you put him first. You put the Lord first in everything you are doing. Praise Master Jesus. Say, this is the whole duty of a man. 2 Corinthians 7 verse 1. 2 Corinthians 7 verse 1. Say, having therefore these promises. What are the promises? We will get the same. Having therefore these promises, dearly beloved, let us clean ourselves from all filthiness. Having these promises, let us clean ourselves from every filthiness of the flesh and of spirit, and perfect holiness in the fear of God. The Lord has promised us many things. And remember, he promised, I will come again. I will come again, I will take my children home, and I will burn the shaft, I will burn the shaft with fire. These are promises that when I come, some will enter into my rest, and some will be destroyed. Now, have you heard these promises now? That is coming again. And remember, Christ don't need to come before you face him. If you fall and die now, you will face him. Praise Master Jesus. So, have you know this? That if you go out now and never come again, there's somebody you must meet. What do? You fear him. You clean yourself from every unrighteousness, from every filthiness, and make sure you perfect your holiness in the fear of the Lord. You live a holy life every day. It's a present continuous. We continue living in holiness until we get there, perfecting holiness in the fear of the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. The Bible told us in 2 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 14. 2 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 14. Said, be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. This is an advice from the Lord. 2 days ago or some days ago, yesterday I was telling Sister, who was that sister yesterday? That Sister Dupe, or yeah, it should be her. Yes. Some days ago, Lord was telling me, say, my son, you can be holy. And if you truly want to make heaven, there are some people you must avoid. There are some property you must take away. There are some things you must not say again. There are some places you must not go again. There are some things you must not do again. If you are able to consider these things, some people you should avoid. Not to hate them, but avoid them. Because as long as these people are in your life, they will always make you to sin. So you try to avoid them. Don't hate them. Check your property around you. There's a thing that you must have to do away with. There's a places you know, if you go to this place, you must sin against God. You stop going there. The things you are doing, stop doing them. With this, you will be able to make my kingdom. I said, sir, you are very correct. Then I begin to check myself. What do I need to take away from myself? What are the character I need to do away with? Are there people in my life that I need to avoid so that I will not sin? Are there people that are causing me to sin? Are there things around me that I should do away with? Are there things in my life that I'm not taking as God in my life? I should take them away. Say, but be you not unequally unbeliever. That thing in your life, it's not necessarily, it must be person. That thing in your life is dragging to hell. Do away with it. That place that you go to, whenever you go to that place, you are not yourself again. Do away with that place. Say, for what fellowship has righteousness with unrighteousness? That thing you are doing is a sin. Don't do them again. Don't put them on again. That place you are going to, stop going there. What are you doing there? You are holy. That place is unholy. That place will defy you. So stop going there. Those people you are gallivanting with, those people you are moving with, they are not like you. They are unholy. Black and white cannot be mixed together. If you mix them together, it will show. This one is white. This one is black. No matter how you are careful, if you go to the market with white cloth and you go to where they are selling oil, oil is everywhere and you are wearing gown, it will stain. So what do? You run from a place where there's oil. And if you don't run away, it will stain you. Praise Master Jesus. And what communion had light with darkness, it cannot be interwoven. Light and darkness cannot work together. Pari passu. Verse 15. And what conquered had Christ with Belial. And what part has the believer with an infidel? It cannot work together. Verse 16. And what agreement has the temple of God with idol? For ye are the temple of the living God, as God has said, I will dwell in them, I will dwell in you, and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. These are the promises of God. The Lord will dwell in you. The Lord will walk with you, walk in you, walk through you, walk by you. And he said, you will be his people. For us to do this, we have to run away from sin. See, verse 17. Wherefore, come out from among them. Come out from among them. Among those people. That thing you are doing, run away from it now. Before that is send you to hell. Praise Master Jesus. And be ye separate. Be ye separate, said the Lord. Now, these are the promises that he gives up before. 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1. He said, said the Lord, and touch not the unclean things. Unclean things. That thing you are playing with. You are playing with serpents. That thing you are playing with. You are playing with serpents. They are telling you, don't put on wig again. You are still living in your house. One day you will put it on again. That trouser as a woman. You are not wearing them again, but it's still in your house. One day, you'll be tempted to wear it. And you'll be surprised as you are just putting your leg. Trouble just sound, boom, the trouser into your waist. That's where he will meet you. So, you better just do away with them. And touch not your clean things. And I will receive you. I will receive you. And I will be a father unto you. And you shall be my sons and daughters, said the Lord of hosts. These are the promises of the Lord. I want to be your father, and I want to be my child. This is where 2 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 1 came from. Having therefore all these promises, what do we do? Let us clean ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and of spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of the Lord. It is simple. You can avoid hell, brother. You can avoid condemnation if only if you will adhere to the word of God. If you will be the doer of this word. Can't you see? It is easy. Say, I will be your father. You will be my child. I will love you. You will be with me in my kingdom. Remember, he told us in John chapter 14, verse 1 to 3. Say, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in me and believe that in my father. So in my father's house, there are many mansions. If it was not so, I would have told you, let not your heart be troubled. I will come again. I'm going to prepare a place for you, and I will come again. And when I come, I will take you to where I am. So where I am, there you shall be also. It is a promise of the Lord. He will do it. He will do it. If only we can run away from sin. Remember, the Bible told us in Romans chapter 6, verse 23. Say, for the wages of sin is death. This is the only thing that will wage you. The only thing that will block you from making heaven is sin. The payment of sin is dead. There's no two ways about it. Many people have gotten their due payment in sin. They are in hell now. If you also die in sin, he will give you your due reward. There's no partiality when you get to that place. He will give you your due reward. So whatever you work for now, if you work holily and righteously, he will give you your crown of life. And if you live in sin, then the wages of that sin, the payment of that sin, is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Can't you see that it is possible for you to avoid hell? It is possible for I to avoid hell and condemnation if we run away from sin, if we run away from anything that has to do with sin, if we fear God and love him. Heaven is sure for us. It is possible. People are there in heaven. Souls are there that are saved in heaven. We can be plus one there. You can be plus one there. People are in hell also. I pray you will not be plus one again in hell in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Mark chapter 9, verse 43. Mark 9, from 43. And if the hand offend thee, cut it off. It's better for thee to enter into life maimed than having two hands to go into hell. You want to enjoy life here on earth, and that enjoyment is condemning you. Brothers and sisters, remember he told us, what shall it profit a man to gain the whole world and lose your soul? What shall you give in an exchange of your soul? How much do you have to buy your soul? Brothers and sisters, gather all the money all over the earth, all the assets in the earth, everything on earth cannot buy one soul. Let every human being on earth bring their money together. All the government on the earth bring their money together to buy one soul. It cannot buy it. So your money, no matter how rich you are, it cannot buy your soul for you. So what do? You run from whatever that will damn your soul in hell. If it's that sin that will take to hell, run from it. It's better that man hate you, that man that wants to take to hell. If it's him that will lay on the for him, it's better the man hates you than you and the man go to hell. If it's that friend, you see that friend is pushing you to hell gradually. You better run from that friend now. It's better that friend hates you than he pushed you to hell, because she might push you to hell and repent from the same thing she's asking to do. And what will you do? You will regret forever. Praise Master Jesus. He said, have you to hand to go into hell? I come again. And if the hand offend thee, cut it off. It is better to enter into life maimed than having two hands to go into hell, into the fire that never shall be quenched. I fear her so much. I fear God before, but since the ministry of reconciliation came and he showed me what is hell, I fear him the more. I don't want to go to that place. It is a God. Say the fire never quench. 44. Say where their worm never die. Brother, when we talk about worm, not this worm that you see here. Worm is bigger than serpent. The worm in hell, it is bigger than serpent. You see this hand? This hand is too small compared to the worm in hell. The worm in hell is bigger than this. If you enter through your nose and pass through your belly, the teeth is like daggers. If you let not believe, no matter how I explain it, it is still worse. It's still worse than what I'm saying. Nobody can explain what how hell look like. Hell is the only thing that can explain it is experience. If you experience it, then you will know how it is. Even though Christ comes now to explain hell to us, you can, it's too much than that. So as I was saying, the worm in hell, their teeth, one of their teeth is bigger than this. Teeth of the worm. And is sharper than nail. It can pierce anywhere. It can enter through wherever, like in hellfire, you are helpless. You are hopeless. They do whatever they like to you. They won't enter anywhere. Fire will be burning inside of you. The Bible says, and they shall be turned into fire. Anything in hell is hell. Oh, brother. Anything in hell is equal to hell. Once you enter hell, you are not hell yourself. So don't go there. Anything that enter hell fire is fire itself. So don't go there. Now you have hope now to run from hell. Better run now. Say, where there are warm, dead not, and the fire is not quenched. Verse 55. Remember, this is Christ speaking now. It's not Apostle Paul trying to say it. It's Jesus Christ saying now what hell look like. And if thy foot offend thee, cut it off. It is better for thee to enter into life than having 2 feet to be cast into hell, into the fire that never shall be quenched. That feet is telling you still go to that place. That place that when any time you go there, sin always follow you home. And you come home and start crying, confessing. One day you will not have an opportunity to get to confess. It will meet you there. Rapture will meet you there. And you will go to hell if you don't repent now. Stop going there. Even if it's your husband that is pushing you there, pray. Pray harder. God, touch this my husband. If it's your friend, run away from that friend now. I cannot tell you divorce your husband now. But I'm praying that the Lord will touch him. If it's your wife, I pray the Lord will touch her. So that you will not go to hell. It's not a place to be. Say, where there are warm, dead not, verse 46. And the fire is never quenched. The Lord was so emphatic. He was saying again and again and again. For 7. And if thy eyes offend thee, pluck it off. That thing that your eye will always say, look, look. Stop looking at it. S. If you take the hell, it's better you close your eyes when you get there. Close your eyes and pass there. S. Anytime you look at that thing, it makes you sin. It makes you lust after the thing. I pray the Lord will help you. The Lord will deliver you from lust in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now, we get to go further to 48. I don't have more time. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 26. Hebrews 10, 26. Say, for if we see willfully that we have, after that we have received the knowledge of the truth, there remaineth no more sacrifice of sin. Praise Master Jesus. Last night, the Lord he gave me a word that fear me. Say, whoever that sin willfully, go to hell willingly. I say, wow! Say, my son, whoever that sin willfully is telling me I am willing to go to hell. If you sin willfully, you go to hell willingly. I said, Daddy, this is it. It is true. Hey, Father, help me. Are you a Christian? You know this is sin. And you are still doing it. You are sinning willfully. And you are willingly going to hell. You are willingly condemning yourself. So, brothers and sisters, whenever you want to do anything, consider it. Is this thing not a sin? If I do this thing, will the Lord be happy? He said, we should hate what he hates and love what he loves. This place I'm going to now, if I go there and rapture, take place there, hey, this place where they are smoking and drinking, can Christ follow me there? This place where they are doing nonsense thing, if I go to this place, now this church I'm going to now, I will get into the all their preaching is the worst, they are evil offend God. If God meet me in this place, am I not in Sodom and Gomorrah? Can anybody be free when the fire comes down in Sodom and Gomorrah? Now the Lord is saying, Lord, come out now. Lord, come out of among them. Let your wife follow you. Let your children follow you. If the fire comes down already, nobody will be saved in Sodom and Gomorrah. That place you are going to, that's where you are serving God. That snuggle of Satan. If fire comes down there, it will devour everything there. So you better run from that place now. For if we see willfully, after we have received the knowledge of truth, we have known that as a woman, wearing trousers is a sin. If you wear it willingly, you are going to hell willingly. Praise Master Jesus. You know you are going to hell. Why would you go to hell? Why would you allow just trust her to take to hell? Why would you allow as a woman? Why would you allow artificial things to take to hell? There are nothing. Nothing is big enough. It's good enough to take you to hell. And I pray I will not go to hell. You will not go to hell in Jesus' name. Amen. He's telling you and I, Jesus Christ is not ready to come and die again. There remaining not sacrifice of sin again. Whoever that enter hell remain in hell forever. Praise Master Jesus. James chapter 1:13-15. James 1:13-15. Say, Lord, let no man say when he is tempted, I am tempted of the Lord. For God cannot tempt a man with evil, neither tempted he any man. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away in his own lust. When he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. That thing is enticing you. Run from it now before that thing becomes temptation. That thing that you are looking is so glitter. Remember, not all this glitter is gold. It might be block. They just spray it with sunshine. If you break, if it break on you, you are finished. Verse 15. When say, but every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. When lust has conceived, it brings forth sin. And sin, when it is finished, brings forth death. And when death is finished, hell come up. Praise Master Jesus. Lust will make you to sin. Sin will kill you. And once you die, hell will come around. I've told us before, hell is like a person. I am opportunity to see it. When you want to die, it will come and take you there. And I pray this will not be a portion in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So, whatever that is enticing you now, before it ties you to hell, run from that thing now. Praise Master Jesus. The Bible told us, I'm closing because of time. Revelation 21 verse 8. But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderer and warmongers and soothsayers and adulterers and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burn with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. Do you want to go there? Brother and sister, if you die now first, you go to hell. The second death is your portion too. There is no escape again. Whoever that die now and find themselves in hell, they are just in the appetizer. A time is coming, you'll be thrown into the lake of fire. Praise the Lord. Everyone in hell now, the hell is preparing them for the lake of fire. No matter what they say about hell now, they're just doing joggy, waiting for the Olympic. That is not the true Olympic. They are only doing joggy first. They are doing practicing. The true Olympic is coming for them, which is the lake of fire. Lake of fire is times millions of hell. Don't go to hell. People go to hell, come back now, they are crying. Hey, hello. Hey, they do me this, they do me that. Hey, in the lake of fire, no one will do you this. You are going to be doing yourself that. You will turn into that worm to kill yourself. Because Satan and everything will be in the lake of fire. So you will not be the worm of yourself to eat yourself. You will not be the fire to burn yourself. You will not be the demon that will be killing. Oh God, have mercy. You will not be the demon of yourself. Because even the demons that are punishing people in hell will also be in that lake of fire. Would you want to go there? The answer, I answer for you. No, don't go there. And the only reason not to go there is to love the Lord. Remember, he told us in John 14:15, if you love me, you keep my commandments and fear him, which is the conclusion of all matter, which is the duty of a man. Fear the Lord and you will be delivered. Praise Master Jesus. When you get home, you read Matthew chapter 10, verse 28. He's talking about that man, you think, if I don't obey him, he will kill me. Say that man can, if God allow him, he can only kill your body. He cannot kill your soul. But there's a man waiting for you that can destroy your body and destroy your soul and destroy your spirit. So don't fear man. The fear of a man is a sin. Only the fear of God that is holy. So don't fear your husband and do what is wrong. Your husband will sentence you to hell. Don't do it. It's better you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I pray God grant you grace and wisdom in Jesus' name. Amen. Revelation chapter 20, verse 15. And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire, where they will become the demons of themselves, where they will become the witches and wizards of themselves, where they will become Satan of themselves. Satan will be crying. The person will be crying. Everyone there will be crying. And while Apostle Emmanuel and everyone on this mountain shall be rejoicing in heaven on the last day in Jesus' name. Amen. Remember again, the title is Be Free from Hell and Condemnation. It's not saying that you can be free. Say, be free. The power of freedom has been given to you. Be free. And say to yourself, I am free now in the name of Jesus Christ.
I am free now in the name of Jesus Christ.
And we all shall be free to the end of time in Jesus' name. Amen. Man, brother and sister, if you are out there, you are not born again, you are on your way to hell. Reverse your car now. Simply say this word after me. Remember, it is wisdom to be born again. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word. I am a sinner. I just realized that I was on my way to destruction, hellfire. But today, I've come to you. Have mercy on me. Forgive me all my sin. Wash me with your precious blood that was shed for me. I accept today as my Lord and personal Savior. Take my name away from the book of death and write it in the book of life. I am born again today. All things have passed away, and all things have become new. Thank you, precious Lord Jesus Christ, for saving my soul. In Jesus' mighty name, I declare. Amen. Brother and sister, wherever you are about the world, that have said it now, maybe you will see it later. I pray the Lord grant you more grace, more strength to run this race to the end of time in the name of Jesus Christ. I must tell you the truth. If I tell you the road is easy, it's a lie. The road is not an easy road. You don't need luggages there. Any little luggage can disqualify you. So please, don't let anybody deceive you that is once you are born again, cars will start coming. Houses will be easy. You are just enter into battlefield now. The Lord, you are not on the Lord's side. Stay with him. Stay by him. And he will stay with you and stay by you also to the end of time in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, my co-worker.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.